Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Duncan Wallace, who is the Technical Director at Chariot. Duncan, a very warm welcome to you and some big news out just this morning. But before we delve into that, perhaps you'd just like to get us back up to speed with the Chariot story.
Yes, great. Thanks, Tom. Good to be with you here today. So Chariot, we are an AIM-listed transitional energy company focused specifically on the African continent. And within that business, we basically have three pillars. We have a gas business, which is focused on Morocco, and that'll be obviously the subject for today's news update. In addition to that, we have transitional power pillar, where we're looking to deliver cleaner, more reliable, and cheaper power to various clients across Africa through renewables, principally wind and solar. And then the final part of the business is a green hydrogen business, where we have a world-class project in Mauritania called Project Nor, which is in partnership with Total Eren.
Understood, Duncan. Now turning to this morning's news, the front-end engineering and design part of your Anchois gas development in Morocco is now complete. What can you tell us about that?
So yeah, the FEED project is a really important step to progress to a field development that we see at the Anchois project. Now, this work was commenced in the middle of last year, and it was off the back of some very successful drilling that we did that completed in January 2022. So the key thing around the FEED is it confirms the development plan that we have, but also then defines the key elements of that development that we're looking to roll out. And thanks to the additional gas that we found, we now see three initial producer wells. That will include the original Anchois 2 well that was drilled by Chariot as one of those producers. Those will be tied back via an offshore flow line and umbilical to a central process facility located close to the coast of Morocco. That capacity is 105 million cubic feet of gas per day is the capacity we're looking at, which has been increased thanks to Anchois 2 from an initial 70 million cubic feet a day expectation we had. Now, from that CPF, we see a feeder pipeline that runs from the CPF into the GME pipeline, which is a large piece of gas infrastructure that's already in place. And that connects us directly into Moroccan power markets and also potentially for export gas into Europe.
So a pretty significant step. What comes next though, Duncan?
Yeah, it is an important step. So we're happy to have completed this work. Of course, bringing a project to development involves several work streams. Next on the engineering is that we've gone out and requested commercial proposals for the EPC phase of the project. So we're looking to get those back in the coming months and look to move the project forward towards sanction. Other work streams that we're working on at the same time are the finalization of the field development plan, which is an important step. That's currently in discussions with our joint venture partners, ONIM, the state oil and gas company in Morocco, and also other work streams such as the environmental and social impact assessment, which is progressing really well at the moment also.
So there's nobody better placed than you, I shouldn't think, Duncan, to get a sense of just how well the project is progressing overall. So perhaps we can get your take.
Yeah. So, those are, some of the streams that we're looking to progress. But an important thing always for us as a company is always to continue look at delivering upsides and delivering growth from everything that we're doing. I mentioned the additional gas we found in Anchois 2. We still see a lot of undrilled gas sands within the Anchois structure and also in neighboring prospective areas around the field. So what we've also been able to do is look at the development drilling campaign for Anchois and see how we can use those wells to drill some of those undrilled gas sands and evaluate the additional prospective resources that we see. Just within Anchois, we see around 754 BCF of best estimate prospective resource in undrilled gas sands. And our development drilling plan sees us actually evaluating those via the deepening of those development wells or potentially using pilot holes to drill those gas sands. So our development campaign essentially drills or delivers a development, but also an exploration campaign all in one. And the cost of that exploration activity is really minimal compared to the overall cost of the development. So it's a really exciting development, a high value gas project, but also the potential to deliver, really a lot of upsides. And I would say that, that unique blend, having that and also the access to markets and infrastructure hasn't been lost on other E&P companies. So We've received a lot of interest from potential partners in the project. And so we're in, you know, in active discussions with potential partners on the project. And that, of course, is a potential source of financing for the development, but also to help us to accelerate growth from the upsides. The other elements around financing and the final components we need to bring together are, you know, the potential project financing. We're working with Societe Generale, SocGen, as our lead financial advisor to bring a debt syndicate together to support the development. And then finally, and perhaps most importantly, is the gas commercialization. We announced just before the end of last year the key principles agreed on gas sales with ONI, who's the state power company in Morocco, and discussions progressing towards a final GSA are progressing extremely well. And we're also looking at a number of other commercialization opportunities for gas that we're, you know, looking forward to closing out and potentially announcing in the near term.
So plenty for people to digest there, Duncan, but I wonder if you might just finish things off for us today by summarizing why it is you think investors can be excited about Chariot.
Yeah, sure, no problem. And I think, you know, as I said at the outset, a key thing for us is always to have a scalable portfolio of projects. And beyond the Anchois development that has fundamentally exploration growth within that development, there's also a much wider exploration portfolio across the Lixus license and the Rissana license area where we truly believe we've captured a basin scale opportunity. So in gas, the upsides are obvious to see. In the hydrogen, green hydrogen business, we're looking to be at the leading edge of the green hydrogen business in Africa, and looking to augment the portfolio with similar large-scale projects to the one that we've announced are progressing in Mauritania. And our recently announced energy trading license in South Africa is really a catalyst to accelerate the pipeline of growth in the transitional power business. So we feel that, you know, all three of those pillars are all scalable. And an important thing always to remember at Chariot is that the Chariot executives and the management team are also inherently closely aligned with all of our shareholders.
All right. Well, we'll leave it there. Chariot Technical Director Duncan Wallace, thank you very much for talking to us at Proactive today.
Great. Thank you, Tom.